Hardly anybody knows more about television than Michael Ausiello. TV Line is a must-read for TV fans and TV insiders. And Michael has done something else that has gotten an awful lot of attention. A romantic memoir that recounts falling in love and losing that love. Book is called Spoiler Alert, The Hero Dies. Michael, good morning to you. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
This is very, very personal stuff. What prompted you to write the book?
I was approached to write it, actually, and it was seemed like an opportunity I couldn't pass up on, an opportunity to pay tribute to my late husband, but also to introduce the world to him, this incredible, remarkable, complicated person.
And what people and there's considerable praise for the book, what so many people have written about it, is it is really warts and all about the two of you.
Yeah.
It is not this sort of,
sugar-coated
version, yeah. Precisely right. Mm.
Yeah, no, I decided if I was going to tell this story, I needed to tell it honestly. We were both imperfect people. Our relationship was not perfect. And I felt like in order to do the story justice, I needed to sort of put most of it out there. I saved some. I didn't give everything away, but there's a lot. There's a lot in there.
How have you been feeling now since the book is out in the world and the reaction you're receiving to it?
It feels incredible. It feels really nice. You know, I get now at least 10, 20 messages a day from total strangers telling me how the book moved them, how they're going through similar struggles, and it has made them feel less alone. That's incredible to get that kind of feedback.
In a very, very detached way, I think some people would think, if I was with a partner, I was, you know, but they became terribly, terribly ill, I'd leave.
Yeah, I can't imagine. I mean, it was never even an option for me. Instinctually, I just knew where I needed to be, by his side, being his caregiver. It was not even a choice.
And do you think of two relationships, the before illness and then during and after?
Certainly, yeah. There was a shift that occurred when we found out that he was sick, a shift in me that, you know, our priorities shifted. We were together for 13 years, and we never had any interest in getting married. The day we found out that he had this form of cancer, I proposed marriage to him, and I was like, let's get married, and a couple days later, we were at City Hall.
Taking pen to paper and putting the book together, is that a healing thing? Is it stirs up more?
It felt masochistic, honestly, while I was writing it. I didn't necessarily feel like I was being healed. I felt like I was just being immersed back in it. Now I feel like I'm feeling a little bit of the healing. Like when I'm getting the reaction from people and seeing that it's moving people, that feels really nice.
What can other people learn from what you went through who might be in a similar circumstance?
Be present for your loved one. Don't take for granted, you know, what you have. Enjoy every minute, but also take care of yourself. That's something that I learned. It's important to take care of yourself in addition to taking care of your spouse, because, you know, in order to be the best caregiver you can be, you need to be healthy and you need to be you need to be in a good place.
And are breaks important as well?
Yes, I wasn't so good at taking breaks, but yes, you know, a couple times I would go out for dinner or to friends. I remember one time I went out and I saw Lady Gaga in concert, which was a huge deal for me because it just, you know, it was really a gift I was giving myself. It felt selfish, but it's important to do that. It really is important to step away, step outside the cancer bubble in order to, you know, be fully present and committed when you're inside the cancer bubble.
Professionally, people know you primarily for your work about television, yeah. Commentary on television. Is this something, this story, I don't know, and this might be a wildly premature question, would you ever like to see it brought from a book to?
I feel like this is a story I haven't seen on television or in movies. To be honest, though, I'm so focused on just, you know, the book right now and not thinking too far ahead. And I'm proud of the accomplishment of this book. Whatever happens after this, you know, we'll see.
And there is this process after one writes a book. I don't know if this took place with you, dealing with editors, dealing with the publishing company and that type of thing. Was that hard?
No, it was amazing. They were so supportive. Simon & Schuster and the imprint Atria, they were so supportive every step of the way. I originally said that I would have this book written in 9 months. It ended up being 18 months, and they were totally patient with me and compassionate. They knew this was a difficult story for me to tell. And it was a completely seamless and comfortable working relationship.
Spoiler alert, the hero dies. Michael, very good to have you today. And we should tell you, by the way, of course, the book digitally and on bookshelves, bookstores everywhere for you to pick up. Really nice to see you this morning.
Thanks so much.
Thank you, Mike.